If you're a real artist, you'll use this part in the recording on the album.
Yeah.
Starting over, we bought no traps. It's part of the common. In the market for chopsticks, the skit starts off with the damn target. It'd be faster to fix it. Thinks of it, writes of it, to congrat no more. Ready or not, off of the center, just missed it. To them, it's just redneck and vaudeville, town rodeo. Are you there or not? I love it. Love talking. They are such dim idiots. Do you want me to kiss her yet? Go kick the devil or love her. Inaugural today. It's the inaugural love it or loathe it. Kick off terrors. I got him to mom. Oh yes. I'll obey the law or against it. It's not a rule. Why don't I tell you about it? The tick of the tag, a rack, little escape, yes? Ceremony. Tell the tiger to wear off. Quarter to knock them. After, let it not eat. Rock until you're rock. Had to remain. Red and adolescent. Relax. Aggressive. Officer core. Hypocritical. Like a turtle die. Adult right ankle. I'm not a good leader. Really old cotton. You want to talk to a lawyer. Reed, wallet, cut it now, boy. You have wanted out of Delaware. He ran away far toward at now ever here. I review on a telegram. You have 1 hour. Ruin, oh boy, I part and let it out over. He rabbit do little the neck right on the floor. Write the number, can it tell the tale of me? Your full lateral weight for after bedtime time I am aware. We will rot your runners, that's not far off the deal. What for? Rough tar hetero. We will lead it for after, and it's that egg gum on towards the way. Your wet straw out not gate, that's the director's stuff. Today he'll lure or read the red little girl. He'll take a pill and rest you. That is a rotten carrot, it's static egg, ton to go, wart stew and rule. Ah, I have the red straw, I could not get it. It's a happy little moment of personality that kind of leaves. The veiled tic-tac delay, and that due for the oral until it is passed out not far written. He is courageous, contagion, like a war strain of eyes. Say it occurs broad, not that it cost my rock of cyanide erected a masculine color roll of bullhead. The party had to live past it. Time that rocked your socks. I can't make it at school. I guess I got it right. I have got sacks full of ray guns enough to last a lot. To Lancelot, he can guess you're full of cast over fire, talk to the girl. I'm sad, I can't, that's a hard rocker tap full. Into the creek, I had to get you to laugh a little. A cemetery faucet, a man of no, it's times of famine, you're in them. A known ruin, a map of summer story, for the mast to copy of the house,
There were continuous streaming red lights moving forward all around me, the sensation of floating, such a smooth, safe sensation, secure, moving so quickly that the experience felt beyond time, an everlasting moment bound between beginning and end, a liquid moment, the solid ground meeting the unrestricted air, not the collision, but the passing through. Ignorance of the anticipated explosion. Swift, arpeggiatic melodies contrasting slow, steadfast ambient, both complemented by a repeating rhythmic funk. Traveling speed had to be well over 100 miles an hour, but then again, it couldn't have been much more over 25. We were tunneling through existence. A roller coaster that won't stop. All I want is for the four-story increase, yet I take no action as the pain caused by the disruption is speculated to be far worse than allowing the ride to run its course. The only true antidote would be to have never decided to board. I chose to do nothing, as that is all that I can do. However, my decision to do nothing is also the choice to allow everything. Therefore, I'm really doing everything, as everything encompasses everything. Passive and active. I can't do nothing. To counter this predicament, I must choose the most minuscule act. I close my eyes. Complete terror. A stationary free fall. Seemingly never ending. I am aware of everything. It's too much. Overloaded by what's going through my mind, body, and surroundings. Three become one. Focus. My eyes are open. My perception has shrunk to the size of a quarter. I'm walking through the desert in this moment. A giant pair of glasses rests in the sand. I can hear the voices of those near me. They are gigantic, yet distorted and distant. Words spell out within the clouds above me. Everyone is just trying to make everyone feel comfortable. Or the conversation is flying around the room like a three-dimensional game of Snake. There are multiple players and multiple overlapping games, each representing something different. The first, conversation, movement is second, thought is another, yet is found in conjunction to all that stirs its own singular entity, music, light, physical energy, both man and man. I'm trying to get everything down, but freedom is dictating. I'm seated upon a stone pillar surrounded by abyss. I'm at a desk accompanied by a glass in pink wheel. A pillow is tied to the top of my head. A plume penetrates. I can see David in the dark sky. His voice is realization spread. I understand nothing that makes sense. A goblin suddenly appears on the ceiling. I run atop a stone wall of a dilapidated castle. It is following my movements as quickly than I can perceive. Huge illuminance. Horrifying yellow eyes. Perfectly round. I'm not running away. I'm running after him. I can see her clung to a 12-foot tall fence adjacent to the highway. It's dark and it's storming. I begin multiple sentences simultaneously and fail to complete a single one. She is silent. I think through her, past barefoot. I do love her so. The fence electrifies with a loud hum and blue sparks of light accompanied by tuning explosive sound waves. There is a naked red-haired man on fire, located on the opposite side, attempting to crush the fence. He succeeds. A gallon of white hot steaming liquid flows out of his penis onto M. Onto M's leg, like spilled milk from a cutter. But hey, I can't handle the feeling of feeling feelings. I'm sorry, I just don't know what I mean. M takes off running across the dilapidated stone wall, but stops mid-stride. except for the irritating 90 degrees to the left. She is frozen in air. Everything is steel. A coiled snake about the length of half a football field. The face slithers up and swallows up in one foot, sucks her insides out, and spits out a skin still resembling her. They're quite afraid. The skin soon floats to the ground back and forth as a feather does. Perception is restored to its original state. With everything that you want to do, like cats and cars. I feel completely disordered at the moment. I'm trying to think of the connection with the sad guy. I just find it like they're all seem exactly the same. Oh, that's sad. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not restricted to my own head. I'm reading it in my head. I'm laying it on my head. Not seem to find a resolution between the urge to act and the desire to continue my current state for eternity. One feels impossible and the other is impossible, without partaking in unhealthy behavior. Moreover, the present behavior would also be deemed as unhealthy to wallow. There's a mental barrier that sometimes sleep can only overcome. This could be the result of needing more rest and unconsciousness. It could also be that I am just prone to becoming stuck in a rut. However the case may be, I have yet to discover a solution. It's actually not entirely true. As I said before, sleep can often help things. But this results in me losing 8 or 9 hours of precious time, most often more, and also partaking in masturbation. But this often leads to losing 1 to 3 hours of time, which would make me depressed if I cope with such a method too often. This method can also get in the way of productivity, as during the periods that I am active, I have little thinking of anything else. This gets in the way of reading, film, music, and discernment. I cannot think straight, which causes me to become irrational. When I make irrational decisions, I feel that I lose my grip on sense of self, which in turn causes me to feel depressed and very anxious. I stated above that I have a distaste for sleep, and it causes myself to lose quite a bit of sleep. I should clarify that I am unafraid to sleep when I feel it is time to have taken a break. The problem that I have is that I'm stagnant sleep. Most often come at times when I do not have this feeling of rhythm. A problem in the past has been that I would never come to this feeling. But at the present moment, I feel like I have it mostly under control. It is sometimes still a struggle. My Lord, my Lord, the only love that could be faith did not exist, did not exist. And I cry out to the all three and five. I wish this love would not persist, and it begins spilling. Water falls through the sky, the big man does not exist. Silence, okay. Quiver. I love you. Quickly, and the gasping air in a quick way. Yes. Crying. So sorry. I have to do this. I need to get better. Again. Yeah. Sternly. I'm glad I did this. Later. I'm glad I was there to ask for it. Today. I'm benefiting from the fact that you did this. Whenever. I'm not happy about anything. In reality, not I. My voice is not your voice. Just continue. To begin with a downward slope, quite steep. Quickly turns to a slight upward incline. Progresses through the mountain style. After some time, the breath. There is no more. No more is, of course, so much more. Here the rain either ceases or de-ceases. And we continue. I have an idea for a story. There is a house with an attic. Inside the attic, there is another house. It is assumed that individuals are living within this attic. Within this attic's house, but no one has ever met them or fully seen them. The residents of the larger house act as though they do not know that this house in the attic exists. Someone, possibly the main character, whoever that may be, goes inside. Not sure for what reason as of yet. Inside the attic's house, which appears quite small, but is in fact very large, is the larger house's interior. The residents of the large house live inside the attic's house. It is unclear, yet, if it is the same people or if there is a different explanation, such as clones, representations, lookalike actors, hallucinations, etc. I am really unsure of who they are. I am really unsure if I will pursue this story. And I'm really unsure of who I am. Ghost, not android. One race, unfortunate. Frightened to end. It is not special. It is just all. You know, speak love of ugly, if that young feeling. It is more important. It is of a higher purpose. It is meant to be. It is special. I want to be a part of it. I want to be a part of the experience. I want to experience someone else. I am not satisfied. I want to be late. This implies a choice. It is ignored. But that doesn't matter. I'm gonna go to the bathroom.
Thank you very much. One of the best cowboys.
Afraid. You know, it was terrifying. I had three encounters with him. I was living where I live now in my apartment with Kristen, but I was working at the paper route also. Those two chapters of my life, they did not overlap. I couldn't be in one place doing the other thing, which is why this was so strange. But I was at the warehouse for the paper route where I used to work. I had to go there every night at 1 a.m. And it was like this big staff meeting, like a big huddled up gathering. It was strange because that is not how that place works. And they were talking about the masturbating man, and they were saying that they all knew that he was someone that worked there, that did the paper route, and no one knew who he was because he worked at 2 a.m. That's how he snuck into people's houses and masturbated outside of their windows. It wasn't just outside, though, that people saw him. If there was a dark room in the house, people would turn on the light in that room and see him standing in there masturbating. After, you know, after thinking they've been alone for like 3 hours. And so the organization at the warehouse, they were having this big staff meeting because they were trying to catch him. You know, this guy is a menace. And I mean, there was a woman, you know, I remember Rod, my boss at the paper. He was there. He wasn't giving the main speech. There was one person addressing like a big crowd. It wasn't him though, it was someone else. And when they put on this, you know, this cute, gorgeous, not a gorgeous woman, but a moderately attractive woman, and she was talking about her encounter with the masturbating man. She was talking about how, you know, this man just appeared, you know, out of thin air in the dark outside of her window at night, and when she screamed, he just ran away. You know, and this has happened to several people, and this woman was talking about it. You know, she was addressing this huge crowd, which is probably something, it was terrifying. And I was at this big staff meeting, you know. This was a very unusual job. This is not the kind of job that has staff meetings. It's not even the kind of job, you know, where even an employee, you're just like a private contractor kind of thing. But they all knew that the masturbating man worked there somehow. I think because, a certain percentage of his victims, they work for the paper. Anyway, I had three encounters with the masturbating man. One of the encounters happened while I was at this big staff meeting, this big crowd. You know, I was near the window. You know, the paper route, everyone showed up to work at 1 a.m. because that's when the truck papers got there. And that's when the big, you know, staff meeting was taking place. way about it. I hear something outside. Turn and look out the window, and there he is, the masturbating man. So I scream, I interrupt the whole meeting. I scream, shout, fuck you. I hear, you know, a man run away into the darkness. And the entire crowd erupts in panic because they knew. I mean, just from that. Because I shouted, I saw him. And the entire warehouse just erupted into a panic. I don't know what happened after that. But I remember two other encounters with this man. And it was when I was by myself in my apartment with Kristen. No, Kristen wasn't there. She was at work. And, you know, I was in the cat room.
After that, you know, I woke up.